the new world of work, fueled by rapid technology enhancements, is transforming organizations around the globe. In the digital workplace, the rules of the game have changed, allowing you to get your job done from anywhere. My name is Ulrika Hedlund. I'm passionate about technology and the impact it can have on our lives. In this video series, I'll share my expertise to help you succeed in the digital world. As a business owner with colleagues and business partners all over the world, I depend on Microsoft Teams to get my work done. I love using Teams because it enables me to do my job from anywhere. With that said though, love isn't the only feeling I've ever felt for Teams. Like all relationships, we have our ups and downs, and boy can I tell you, I've had a lot of frustrating experiences using Microsoft Teams and a lot of embarrassing mistakes. So in this blog post, I thought I would share some of those mistakes with you and tell you how you can avoid them. Mistake number one, forget that your camera is on. This is by far the most common embarrassing mistake that not only I, but also other people that I've had meetings with do. You're in a meeting. Initially, everyone has their camera on, fully aware, smiling, and talking to each other. Then the meeting continues and someone starts presenting. At this point, you've totally forgotten that you have your camera on and you don't see it yourself if you're watching the presentation in full screen mode, but others do. This is when the charade begins. When you don't know that you're on camera, you start being yourself. This can be quite embarrassing. To top it off, people might even be recording the meeting. How to avoid making a fool of yourself on camera. I really wish that my laptop camera would go bright red when it's turned on so that I knew when I was on camera, but it doesn't. And I don't think yours does either. So the best recommendation I can give you is to have the camera turned on when you're actively engaged and speaking to others in the meeting, and then turn it off when you or someone else is presenting. If you make this into a habit, you'll be more engaged in the meeting and you'll also lessen the chances of you making a fool out of yourself. Mistake number two, write something in a chat in the wrong chat. Every time you have a meeting in Teams, a team group chat is created with everyone in the meeting. This is really convenient because you can post things in the meeting that you might not want to say. For instance, post a question when someone is presenting. The interesting thing is that this meeting chat continues and is live even after the meeting has ended. This is great since you can follow up on discussions even after the meeting. It's not so great though if you mistake it for another chat. I can't tell you the number of times where I've written something about a meeting, for instance, how totally boring the meeting was, in a chat to colleagues, only to find out I posted it in the meeting chat. How to avoid looking like a jerk in meeting chats. I guess the first recommendation to stop looking like a jerk is to stop being one. Try to always be professional. With that said though, we're all humans and Teams is our digital office and sometimes you just need to let off some steam. The good thing with Teams is that you can delete messages you have posted. Just be aware though that someone might have already seen the chat before you had a chance to delete it. Mistake number three, post a message in the wrong team. This mistake is quite similar to the previous one about posting a chat in the wrong chat, but it actually deserves its very own spot on the list. When you're working in Teams, you frequently and quickly switch between different teams and channels. I usually compare different teams to houses and channels to rooms in the house. Say that you have a leadership team with the different channels, finances, employees, and partnership. And a media production team with the channels Customer Projects, social media work, and video updates. If you're not careful, your message might end up in the wrong team. God forbid you intend to write in the leadership employees channel that you need to lower your overhead costs and cut down on staff salaries, but accidentally post it in the media production team instead. How to avoid total mutiny. The best way to avert this issue is to make sure that you understand how teams works. In our company, we don't let people join a team unless they've taken our Storyals enhanced teamwork topic and they need to be certified to be let on board. Secondly, a good recommendation is to add visual team icons to more easily keep various teams apart. Personally, I always use the icons in PowerPoint and save them as images that I upload to our teams. Again, if you realize that you've made such a mistake, you can delete the message. Just know that if someone has turned on channel notifications, they will see that message in their activity feed, even if you've deleted it. Mistake number 4. Set up a Teams meeting that no one knows about. For years, we've been inviting each other to meetings using Outlook, and most of us feel pretty comfortable doing that. Then Teams comes along, and now we can invite to meetings in Teams as well. Teams meetings can be held in channels so that everyone who's part of the team can join the meeting. That is super cool, but there are a few new twists that everyone might not be fully aware of. For example, when you schedule a meeting and select a team and channel, you might think that the team members will get an invitation to this meeting. They don't. It's only visible in the team's channel conversation window. This might be a bit embarrassing if you've planned a kickoff meeting for everyone in the team and no one shows up. How to avoid being all alone in meetings. So the easiest way to make sure you don't have meetings that no one knows about is to add each person you want to invite to the meeting in the participant box. You might think that one of the key reasons to having a team is that you can treat it as a unit and invite everyone at once. But no, you have to manually invite every person you want to the meeting. The good thing is, though, you don't have to feel bad if you don't invite everyone because the meeting is visible in the conversation window, so everyone who wants can join the meeting. It's almost like having a meeting with a door open. Another way to avoid this is to send out the Teams meeting invitation via Outlook, but then your meeting will not be visible in the channel in Teams. Mistake number 5. Make unwanted changes to a shared document. The final point on the embarrassing mistakes in Microsoft Teams list is when you make unwanted changes to a shared document. If you're moving from an older version of Office where you manually had to click Save and Save As, this one is one for you to watch out for. In Teams, all documents are saved to SharePoint Online, and all changes you make to a document are automatically saved as soon as you make them. Imagine that you open up a customer presentation your team has been working on. You want to make a similar presentation for another customer. So you open up the presentation, start changing the name of the customer, and then go to do a save as, only to realize that the changes have already been saved. Whoops! How to avoid being the team idiot. So how do you avoid being the team idiot? Always, always, always start by making a copy. Do save as, and then save the file into a new one, and then make your changes. If you still happen to make this mistake, just save your document as a new one, and then go back to the original document and just type version history in the search box at the top of the application. You'll see a history of all of the changes made to the document, and then you can click restore to go back to the document the way that it was before you started making your changes. Phew. Now that I've shared these mistakes with you and told you how to avoid them, I hope you'll have a less bumpy relationship with Microsoft Teams. You might have another mistake that you frequently do. If so, I'd love to hear about it. Thank you for watching. Bye.